del gioco creativo e dell'immaginazione negli scacchi. Ho tradotto il titolo, basta, non so più di bene. Please.
Beautiful idea. And during the lecture I will give you questions so you can decide for yourself which move you will play over the board. If you make a decision, just make a sign for me that you got it. Not tell something, just make a sign that you got it, and when the majority of our auditorium will sign, I will continue. Okay? So let's start. This is game. My game is Stanislav Novikov, grandmaster from Russia. Also very creative player, and I played white. He was 1 point behind and wanted to win with black, and this was preamble to a very exciting game. So he played modern defense with c6, h3. I started with a decent move to wait. This is some kind of semi-waiting move. I wanted to wait which plan he wanted to implement. So if he plays d5, I play knight f3, and in this modern Tarokan, h3 is very useful. But on the other hand, if he plays d6, like he played in the game, I already did not commit to knight f3 and can still play both knight f3 or bishop e3 or f4 like I did in the game. But actually that was, you know, when you play in internet, there is mouse sleep. Yes, when this is some kind of hand sleep, I play this without hesitation. Immediately f4, because I want at that time I always played 3 pawns against this pierced setup. But actually I wanted to play play bishop e3 and then like knight f6 and f4 then, or maybe b5, a3, knight d7, f4. This kind of position I aimed for. But I played f4 immediately and then recognized that I did something wrong, maybe. So this is my first question. What is the problem with f4?
If I just continue with e5.
Yeah, you should just sign, make a sign that other people can So yes, e5. E5 is the move which highlights the drawbacks of f4. Now both d4 pawn hands and also queen h4 is the real threat. Well, I was very disappointed that I missed such thing on fifth move. But then I spent 10 minutes. 10 minutes not calculating lines, just to... Yes, to try to yourself. Okay, in the work, I calculated briefly lines, so I don't lose. So it's okay. So just imagine that I play black. I will get, in worst case, I will get slightly worse position and will play. Why not? So when I was quiet, I continued to calculate lines. And I played knight f3 here. But then at home, I found that even this move f4 is enough to fight for advantage. And now I will show how. So the best move was d takes e5. Queen h4 check, king e2, d takes e5, knight f3, bishop g4. They sideline that if queen comes back that I can take a pawn, king f2, and nothing wrong happened this way. But again, bishop g4 is the main continuation. And now white has two ways to continue. One of them is g3, so black cannot take on g3 because bishop hands. Black takes, king takes, queen goes back, and bishop d3, knight d7, bishop e3, and say long castle, and maybe even moves like queen g1, aiming to queen side and involving group from a1 to d1, and still very playable position. But I will show you even more critical continuation for white. White can take on g4, queen h1, and queen d6. And now, suddenly, white threatens a very strong knight d1, knight f2, threatening the black queen. And the best what black can do is knight a6, knight d1, rook d8, queen takes, knight f2, trapping the black queen, so queen h6, g5, queen h5, g4. So, black, for this reason, black might take, must take, and now we reach a balanced endgame where black enjoys better pawn structure, but white pieces are more active and better developed, so it's maybe about equal. So f4 actually is not a mistake. It's just some kind of fear for white, but nothing wrong. But let's come back to the game continuation. Because in the game there were even more interesting things. Knight f3, he took, I took, queen h4, king e2, and he played queen e7. What is logical, okay, he forced by king to the center and then come back to normal development. King f2, knight f6, e4 hands, bishop d3, and now he decided to present my king in the center because with normal continuation like castle. I play rook e1, next move king goes to g1, and like Philidor type of position for both sides are pretty much okay for white. He played, interestingly, knight g4, I took on d4, bishop e3, and my king is still in the center. But I already have a lead in development. So almost after every move, I remind myself that my position is okay. Don't worry. Well, it is not every day when you play with a lot of pieces and the king with king on e3. So not only calculated lines, but also some kind of auto training. to be quiet. And he continued d5, what is a logical move. And now I'm proud of what I did in next several moves. I started with g5, which is not so easy move to see and make. But for example, if I plays e5, then f6 opens up the center, it is not what I want to allow. If queen f3, pawn takes on e4, and still opens up the center. It's play for three results, but I wanted to play g5, and if black takes on e4, knight takes e4, and now it's already knight f6 trap in lines. No, not immediately, because knight is pinned, but later. And d4 doesn't work, because king safely takes on d4, and because of only one developed piece on e7, black can do nothing real against white king. And after queen b4, king come e3, queen b2, king d2. Now king is safe, and white enjoys his development advantage. Now white is better, even better. For this reason, he did not play d4, but played bishop e6, e5. I tried to close the center, okay, with such a king. d4 does not work again, for the same reason. Knight d7. And here is the easiest question of my lecture. Is first, I wanted to play queen f3 in the same style, but quickly found that this is a mistake. Why? Most of you already found that queen f3 allows mate in 3 or loses a knight. D4, okay, when black pieces are already well developed, it works and mate. Other moves are king d2. But now double threat on b2 and f4 is not good. And king f2 I played in the game. No double threats at the moment. He played queen before, but now I can protect both pawns with queen c1. This is which I played in the game. But it was as a continuation, also very interesting, play queen d2. Queen takes on b2, rook b1, queen e3, rook b7. I was afraid that my rook can be trapped on b7, but analysis showed that it is not the case. Knight b6, rook c7. And rook attacks c6, say queen c5, king g3, king d8, rook b7. So now black king is also stuck in the center, and there is no way to take the black rook, because king c8, bishop a6. Bishop c8 not possible because rook f7. And rook f8 protecting f7 allows rook h7, and still bishop cannot move because f7 is a pawn hand. And it's also very interesting position, maybe even slightly better for white. But that was too difficult for me to get this over the board, so I played safely queen c1. Mm-hmm. Castle. And now one more unexpected move, which I am proud for. If I play king g3, he can sacrifice a pawn h6. And then after g takes h6, play f6. And open up the king side and play against my king. Also, after a3, it's the same line. Again, black king is safe, and if he opens up the king side, white is in great danger. For this reason, I played rook h6, just to keep the king side closed. Again, not an easy move to see and make, but now king side is closed. King will be safe on g3, and later, slowly, I can start an attack on the queen side. D3, check. G3, C5. So, now white is ready to queenside attack, and I played before sacrificing a pawn. He took it, that was a brave decision, but maybe not correct. Better was to play C4, Bishop E2, and this kind of semi-closed position is produces chances for both sides to win. He played C takes B4, A takes, Queen B4, and Knight B5. Now A7 hands. A6 and Rook B1. He played Queen C5. And now I have another question for you, more difficult than previous. What happens if Black plays Queen A4? There is some hint. There is very unusual tactics.
With knight.
So sorry. Give other people time to think.
Okay.
C3 and knight C3.
Knight C3? Queen C6 maybe? So that, the answer is Queen B2.
Queen B2,
yeah? Yes, Queen B2. Mm-hmm. And if black takes, the rook A1, and suddenly Queen is trapped. It's just two moves, but unusual configuration. So he played Queen C5, Knight D6, Knight B6, and this is the moment of a real question. Now I will give you maybe 7 or 10 minutes because this is the most difficult. White can win here by force. And maybe to give a little hint, white rook is in attack, white knight is excellently placed. Queen is ready to continue with queen b2, maybe move or maybe bishop is close to also aim it on queen side. So the only piece which does not involve to attack is rook h6. And white have a tactical way to involve it into play. How to use it? And G takes?
For C7 and if bishop take knight we take the horse on
this F5 move we win the game for Bayern. He took on D6 but the main line continues. He takes F7 and suddenly knight F7 for was rook. And bishop takes, rook takes b6, now and bishop a6. And all pieces involves to attack. And white wins by force. He took on d6, c takes, bishop c8. Because of if queen d6, queen f4, and after exchange of queens, both pieces, bishop on e6 and knight on b6 can. So black loses the whole rook for the six on bishop c8 and now queen b2. Yes, I know the queen is also ready to include itself to attack at now b6 and h8. Both hangs and king f3 can continue to stay in the center, but again it's okay, now white is rook has extra rook and I won in a few moves. So just gets to g1 and it's so much. Yes, and here is that. So this game showed how unexplored line can be a starting point of a very exciting game, and it's very important not to lose your mind, even if you do something wrong. The chess is very rich, very rich, and you still has a lot of possibilities to do something and to win or make a draw against your opponent. So that was the first game. The second is maybe the best combination of my chess career. I played it back in 1998 when I was Continent Master, but still with such imaginative play, I saved half a point against a strong GM. So now we move quickly to the critical position. I played with white and it was worse, much worse. Now black has extra pawn. Actually, if somebody of you saw my website, you would find this position. But if not, I will show. This position is much better for black. It's true. Black has two bishops, extra pawn, and more safe king. I even cannot imagine how this idea came to my mind, but now I played rook e1. And my opponent could just play bishop f7 and preserve all the advantages of his position. But he found no reason to take on a2. Okay, if I give him a pawn, he took it. And now I try to find what I had in mind when sacrificing this pawn.
Bishop H7.
Okay, takes.
Rook E8. E8.
Yes, rook takes, queen takes, king g7. Let's look at this line. Bishop h7, queen h7, rook e8. Takes, king g7. Okay, there's queen e7, queen d7, maybe king goes here. It looks like no perpetual. Say check. Bishop g8, check, queen g7, check, bishop h7, and d8 square is protected by bishop, so no perpetual here. Not bishop h7.
Bishop c6.
C6.
Where?
Queen.
C6.
Bishop c6.
Yes. With idea rook
e8, but now bishop f7. Bishop took on a2 and come back and protects everything. And now black is already 2 pawns up.
Ah, yeah.
Bishop f7.
Yeah,
it's
a good. Queen for h7. Check.
Queen h7.
Queen take h7.
Take h7.
Okay, it's the same as bishop h7. Queen takes, rook takes, rook check, rook check, king goes probably here, and now rook d2, and bishop d5 hangs, and rook b2 hangs, and how to continue, this is not layout. I told you, I think this is the best combination in my chess career. Don't search for easy ways.
Bishop d5, if bishop take.
Maybe b3.
Bishop takes.
C4. Four.
You got it.
Bishop d5.
Yes, bishop. Yes, b3. Well, at this moment, my opponent look at me like an idiot and took on d3 almost immediately. And I play c4. And now he also played quite quickly bishop c4, but now this was the critical moment. He could still make problems for me to reach a draw. At first I will show, okay, if somebody not got the idea, still we will continue with game continuation, bishop c4, then bishop d5. And after bishop d5, it is suddenly stalemate. Yes, from this middle game position, white sacrifices every piece.
Not easy to find.
And what is that was the imagination that we really should do. Just in position.
You know, give you the hand.
I can understand actually how this mosaic came to my mind is here, because I saw the final position here when played donkey one. But sometimes it happens, miracles. So we can look on other continuation. If black takes, okay, B4 is a very bad move because of bishop d5, then rook e8 and white wins. h6, then queen h4, and now when black bishop is cut from main battleship. Now rook e7 is already threatened, white again is better. And now king h8 and rook f8, two main moves which poses problems for white. We can start with king h8 and here bishop h7. So the difference is the black bishop is cut by c4 pawn. And now in lines, similar lines we will start. White already has perpetual check. Bg7 check, bg6 check is familiar motif. Check and black king is cut with queen and it's draw. And if queen g8 and check, check, check from d5, check from c5. And king e8, not queen c7, but queen c6. And king cannot go to d8 because of queen a8. Queen f8 is repetition, queen c5. And if king comes to 7th rank, then queen takes the bishop with a check, and of course it's also black cannot win. And also bishop d1. One more try for black, but here also white make draw, check, 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 and take b5. Mm-hmm. And it is a first draw. So king h8 cannot force problem. Mm-hmm. And the best move was rook f8. After rook f8, the best for white is take on b5, take on b5, and then here, in this position, or very similar line, bishop g3, rook go to b1, I cannot take on g3 because of rook f1, f1 mate, queen b5, bishop d5. And we reach this position where black, yes, black has two pawns. But if white exchanges major pieces, even in cost of knight, it will be draw because of wrong corner. So white is very close to make a draw. And of course, this is big progress if we compare with our initial position when I played rook e1. So the combination was completely correct, even if still black preserves maybe some chances to win here. But it's already much less than in the initial position. Yeah, but as I already told, the game ended like this. the third game, which I didn't plan to include in this lecture, but especially for Andrea. He told me one thing during our game from the first round, and I remember that I have something very similar in my practice as well. Again, we go to critical position quickly. Have a question for you. What continuation for white can you suggest? You know, we talked about similar things.
Maybe King G5.
Bishop take G4 and the King G5.
Take and King G5.
Take G4 first, because King G5 is maybe too advantageous, adventurous here, but after Bishop G5, King G5, yes, and King is pretty safe on H6 and helps White to mate Black King. It's still not not the end of the day for Black. He took on A2. Queen is ready to take on G2 and then have Queen H3 checks for King H6, Rook F1, Bishop H6, okay, rooks, black rooks are connected as well, King H6, so now Queen G2, what was I doing? I already forgot. He played Queen E2, and now one more question: but how to continue here for White? So he was forced to play Queen C2, and here White reached win end game.
But if Queen G2,
yes. Explore this line. Queen G2.
Rook H1.
Rook H3. Queen H3. Yes, yes, yes.
H4. H4.
H4. Maybe.
You cannot take the rook because of this man.
Maybe H4 was my idea. Actually, I don't remember. I thought that I did not want to include this game. It was my last time in tennis. Queen E3 maybe. Queen E3 was my idea.
Queen
E3. Queen E3, yes. It's why he played Queen.
Different.
While he played Queen E2, he protected E3 and protected G4. And if Queen G2, then Queen E3 and...
Queen H3,
Yes, bishop e3 take, rook g1, knight f7, and now
yes, g5. Yes, but the queen h3 changes
queen
h3.
Queen takes, rook g1, and knight f7, then white is going to win because rook e7 is coming.
Yes, and now as the rook comes to g7, I think
I don't know.
So that's all what I wanted to show. But if you want to continue, I can find a little more examples. Change the term, and I will show four so you who play Sicilian defense. White wants to mix two setups. Okay, white started to play like in English attack, bishop e3. But then came to different plan, bishop e2 to classical plan. And now black has many moves, bishop e7, knight c6, knight bd7. But I'm sure that exactly this position with this bishop e2 and bishop e3, the very best of white's move for the very best move for black is queen c7. It's very difficult to claim something on such an early stage of seventh move, but I'm sure the queen c7 is the best continuation. Now black is ready for active setup with b5, bishop b7, and with classical position of white bishop, white is not so well prepared to meet this active setup b5, bishop b7, knight b7, because f3, now bishop on a2 is senseless. But immediate b5 does not work because of bishop f3. And now black rook is in great danger. And black must continue e5, knight f5. Where white is better. But queen c7 prepares b5. And actually, white has different setups against this line. But never get an advantage. For example, castle, then b5. And the only active plan for white is a4 and knight a2 and c3. White tries to use his development advantage to open up the position, but if black continues b3, not taking this pawn, or queen b3, bishop e7, and the position is still same close, but black is much better in the center and have a lot of good squares for his pieces. Bishop e7, knight d7, knight c5, and d5, maybe e5 later. Everything is okay for black here. And knight b4, knight d7, f4, d5, bishop d6, and again, black enjoys great position. So, returning to this, to 7th move, queen c7. So, for you, for all of you who plays Sicilian knight of with black, I suggest, strongly suggest in, this continuation. Against bishop e3, e6, bishop e2, that you play queen c7, and then b5. If white meet a4 here, this line with a4, black plays b6, bishop b7, knight b7 with the same ideas. It's very active and very good for black. To win this position
today.
Yes, today in the morning. This is a winning position. She should play rook f2 or rook h2 to attack my king from h6 or f6 if I play bishop d5. She played rook e2 is mistake, and now she can attack my king, and white is winning. This is the Philidor's position, but do you know how to win? So the method is now rook a8 is made threat. So black has basically two defenses. One of them is rook b8 is easier to refute. Because rook h7, rook h8, my threat. And here, king b6, rook b8, white wins the rook. It's very easy, it was game continuation. But the strongest was rook d8. Now, black ready to meet rook a8 with rook c8, and nothing happens. Say if white makes, okay, just a random move like rook a1, rook c7. It's very important motif. If I play bishop
d7,
rook d7, yes, and bishop d7 is stalemate. And if again some random move, we can. I will show you early in the game. It's so-called second rank defense. King e7. So if you are on weaker side in that endgame, remember this position is very important. It's very basic position. King on e7. Okay, king on king and rook. Two squares each of other, and it is not possible to break this defense. Say. Rook h2, king d8, check, king d8, nothing white can do. And as I showed you, if white makes progress, say progress like this, black legs play rook d7 and it's drop. So, how to win this? Rook f7, f7, or h7, no difference. Again, we threat mate. Again, black has basically two defenses. One of rook e2 to be ready to meet rook f8, bishop e8, and the second one is king e8. King e8 is easier to win for white, rook f1. Now bishop c6, check, and rook f8, the threat. Rook d2, killing the bishop. Rook b1, from this side. Rook b8 is made threat, and if king wants to go, rook g1, and now rook g8 is unstoppable. And if rook e2, and then they switch to the other side. So we play rook g7 first. Because the rook, black rook is the very best placed on the second rank. I will show you later why. So white makes a waiting move, rook e1, and now switch on the other side, rook b7. Again, black has two continuations, king c8 and rook c1. Say rook c1. We saw a very similar position with rook c2 few moves ago. Yeah, that was the position. But now white has bishop b3. And black cannot check from the d-file. Rook c3 to have this check. Now bishop e6. Rook b8 is making threat. Check bishop d5. Rook c3. And now when rook came to c3, white again switched to the previous plane, rook d7. If king e8, rook g7. And now, with rook on third rank, black has no defense rook f3 and cannot stop rook g8. So the best position for rook is on second rank, but with this Zugzwang ideas, white wins. And if king goes to c8, then again rook f7, but make threat king b8. Rook b7 and rook b4. And now again bishop e6 is making threat. And if rook b3, then rook a4. And the black is mated from other side, because again rook b3 is not possible. So this is the method of winning this position. To force black rook to go to third rank, where it has no so many squares for the defense, like on second or first rank. But to get how to win this position, it's better to try half an hour or 1 hour against the computer. Because it's not so easy. It's it takes like 10 or 11 moves, and you need to know this method because it's very important. Actually, I had maybe 5 times in my practice to get this position with rook and bishop against rook from both sides, and not always was positive result for me.
But today is positive for you.
Yeah, today was positive. But took a lot of energy.
Yeah.
one more game. This game is the same player, international master from Azerbaijan, Abdulov. Where I played King H, this idea with King G5, King H6. And this is another game with the same player. Somehow it happens that all games with him consist of my best game. It's very, very trendy line and fashionable. Sweeter and other guys play this with black. We go to middle game position. Oh. So knight d4. Yeah. So knight d4. Now black could continue with g6, which is very natural. But after bishop e3, pawn takes, knight takes. Black, white has a very strong attack, and actually white is win. Queen d8. Check. Bishop d4 and rook e3, and black can do nothing against rook g3 and queen g8. It looks strange, but actually black with extra piece have absolutely nothing to do. He played knight c4, d3, knight e3. And g6. Bishop e3. Yeah, it's the same. It's the same like in previous notes. If black takes on f5, knight takes f5, queen g4, bishop d4, rook e3, white wins. But he played knight c5. And won a pawn on e4. But this is not problem for white, because black has holes around his king, it's first. Knight on a3 is out of place, and white can continue with bishop f1, slowly increasing pressure against black's position. Before, he tries to get his knight back with knight b5, queen d2. White stops this idea because knight b5, queen d4, and also queen f4 can come in the nearest future. Bishop b7, knight f5. Okay, white is ready to attack. Of course, it's not possible to take, but knight e4. But rook e4, queen b2 first, f6, rook e4. Queen f6. White cannot win immediately, but again it is clear that there's so many pieces on king side, but is very close to mate black. Queen c7, knight b6, rook c1. Every move attacks something. Black has no way to avoid these attacks. Queen d7, knight b7, king b7, and now you see the game continuation. I wanted to give you a question. What to do? Just try not to see to the game notation. find it by yourself. Did you find any ideas?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. It's a variation pattern.
Variation pattern, yeah. How to continue after queen d7?
Bishop take this. Yes, queen d7. If take queen, we take the rook and black can't defend the mate. If take with the rook, we check with the rook.
No. If that would be queen of fighting mate.
Queen f8.
Queen f8.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
If queen d7.
Queen d7.
And don't forget, if if I know one move for black, then say queen d6. black can be more or less okay.
Rook c8. If take with the rook, bishop take
c8.
Okay. If queen take the bishop, we take the tower, the rook.
Then the rook e1 check, king h2, queen c7 check, and then. No, it's also that. Rook c8.
Okay.
And after rook f7, queen f6. Now black is already helpless. Okay, the last move in the game.
Okay.
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 Okay. Okay.
Okay. One more attacking move. Yeah, I listened to you got it. Rook c7. Rook c7 is like a diamond because queen c7, queen e8, rook f8, queen f8, and the mate.
Finish it.
Okay, that's all.
Quality sacrifice is a typical pattern in the Spanish opening. I read it in a type of book.
But that was nice that after 25 moves, we started on 26 moves, and 10 moves in a row, or 11 moves in a row, white attacked with every move. Knight f5, queen b2, attacking, rook e4, queen f6, rook knight d6, attacking rook. Rook c1 attacking queen, knight d7 is where it takes, bishop a6 taking, again threat against queen.
No, necessary.
Queen e6 and rook c7. Every move is taking or sacrificing something.
At the 19th move, was knight f3 the best move, or maybe queen f3 could do better?
Where?
On the 19th move, after b3, yes.
Okay, knight e5 was also possible,
yeah.
But that was his idea to run, to win this pawn on before. Knight e3 attacking bishop, and then the g6 and knight c5, and to...
Yeah, okay, but maybe after knight e5, black can survive it.
Yeah, it's still slightly better for white, or maybe... better for white, not slightly, but still the game continues. But it was not possible to imagine here that this position is so bad for black. Because it looks like almost all the black pieces are in the center, and with extra pawn, he is maybe not so much worse, or even not worse at all. But actually, it's almost lost.
Thank you.